Okay, so we're starting with the first application. Building permit 19295 for 361 Sorrel Street?
361, yeah.
Yes, okay. So you can begin.
Okay. So I don't know if we should start.
What
do we
would
start
you like
with,
to see first?
Yeah, which we start with. David, do you want to explain?
Yeah, would you like just a quick introduction to what we're proposing? Is that the way to do it?
Sure.
Yeah, if you can start maybe with photos of the house and the neighbors and Google Earth.
So we have to go back to the first.
Do you remember where you put those?
Yeah. Sorry, guys. Maybe you want to pause the recording.
Yeah, that's okay.
Which address is this one? I'm sorry.
This is 361
Sorrel Street.
Right.
It's just south of Westwood.
I'm going to open up my other computer screen, actually. So I can see.
They were in 2 weeks ago, and he was asked to return with the architect.
Can you guys see that?
They were in.
Oh, we saw this. Yes. Yes.
That's in front of the house, basically. Facing south.
I think we were fairly good with the design and everything. It was just a matter of making sure that the drawings were reflecting what was being done.
Yeah.
Right. Yes. Right.
Yeah.
So do you want me to go to the drawings or should I keep going with the photos?
Yeah, actually, I think you probably got, were we all here, Stanley, Claudia, were you guys here for this presentation?
Yeah, but I looked at the drawings that were submitted. They look like the same drawings.
No, there was some more enhanced existing condition drawings I think were submitted on Monday, maybe?
Yeah, unfortunately, I was not able to download. I needed it in one PDF to email it to everyone. So they haven't seen the drawings that you sent in on Monday.
Okay, so
if we can post them now, that would be great.
Yeah.
Do you guys, Pamela, do you have it on your computer or?
Yeah, I'm gonna share it.
Okay.
Can you guys see this?
No,
you can't see this.
There you go.
Yes.
So, David, do you want
to? Okay, so that's the proposed design. P3 is the existing conditions.
We want to go to that one first, then.
P3. Yeah.
Okay.
Elevation.
Well, that's second floor. Hold on. I have a P1, P2. I don't see a P3.
You should have P3 there.
Yeah, or, existing exterior elevation.
Right. Okay, so do you have P3?
That's seemingly right. Here we go.
Yeah.
Okay. No. Okay. Sorry, guys. This is going to be a really fun recording, right?
Pamela, you might want to unshare your screen for a second and then reshare it.
Okay. All right. That's exactly
better.
Can you guys see that?
Yes,
yes. That's
good. Just right. Zoom in on it.
Okay, so that represents what's there now in the area of the house that they're proposing to add on to. And you know, presently the Nation says they have a long 1.5 story home with a 2-story addition on the east end. That's the side that's visible from Sorrel Street. And as on the drawing, you can see that's the taller 2-story addition on the right hand side. And what they're proposing is to add a new 2-story addition adjacent to that, just to the west, and a 1-story addition below with a covered porch that extends across the width of both those additions.
Right, but right in that drawing, right where your cursor is, doesn't the grade drop down so there's another lower floor that should be seen there?
Well, it's hidden under the grade is up and then slopes back to the house, but it's hidden, if you look at the photographs, by the deck. So there, it's really nothing visible from the straight on view. So if you go back, to the, on the east side of the house, the grade has dropped all the way down, but it doesn't do that until it comes around the corner.
Okay.
So you see where on the east elevation of the existing elevation, it is, it's basically 3 stories. But the view from the south, you basically see just the majority of the skirt of the deck. There's okay. There's not a prominent, you know, architectural feature under there that's visible.
Okay.
And so they're also proposing to add a dormer over the existing living room, which is where the cursor is to the left of that dormer right now, and expand the existing deck. And the concept behind the proposed design is basically to replicate the existing 2-story roof line on the new 2-story addition to both complement the existing design and make it look less like an anomaly, like it's all by its lonesome out there. And then basically to use the 1-story shed, you know, addition below to visually bring the upper roof lines down, kind of de-emphasizing the height, the way the existing shed roof porch on the east side does, and, you know, get the house to sit down, give it some coherency, and that now you have, you know, the 2 2-story additions are basically in tandem, and it cleans up one of the major steps in the roof, that transition from over the roof that's over the front door as you go right, then there's a step in the roof, then it goes up to a very shallow dormer. And then as you go farther across, you can see it, you know, the verticality gets very much more emphasized. And so there's like 3 very disparate, you know, design elements going there on there. And so the idea was to kind of replicate the existing, you know, gable roof line all the way to the right, put it in place of that shallow dormer, and then try to knock the height of it down by bringing out the shed, you know, addition underneath the 2 and making the house sit down there so that it's more in keeping with, you know, that long roof line that is to the left that goes on and on over 100 feet to the left. And so it's basically trying to make the roof line a little bit more coherent.
Can we go back to that drawing that you were just describing? Because here we have the existing one.
Yeah.
The proposed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
So 1 second.
There we go.
Hang on, I'm gonna get the. Okay. Are you seeing this? Mm-hmm. Or not yet?
Yeah, there it is. So basically on the front, you can see that the, you know, the proposed roofline of the 2-story addition is, you know, it's the same pitch and same width, but, you know, the window treatment is different. That, you know, step in the roof has been cleaned up. And then to the left of the proposed 2-story addition is that little dormer with the 3 little square windows that would be over the, like the clerestory over the existing living room. And
library.
Library.
Well, library, yes. And, you know, again, if you look to the right, then that, you know, the one story addition that comes, that's proud of the two second story additions, essentially, that roof line, that shed roof now goes across the width of both of those second story additions, and then visually makes them, you know, kind of sit on a lower roof and brings the verticality of that whole end of the house down, because the rest of the house for the 100 feet to the west is very horizontally oriented. So it's a device to try to make the house sit down some and not look so, one end look so disparate from the other.
And so that's that's a completely new longer shed roof, even on the existing part of the house?
No, that's the existing shed roof between the proposed second story addition and that existing dormer there. But the only change is that the step in the roof has been replaced by the second story addition, which is, yes, right there. And the transition, I think, is helped by having the small dormer there, you know, over the existing long horizontal roof line. So it's not so abrupt, that, you know, taller second story addition going down straight to the shallow one story existing house. So
yeah, because before this was just roof, this dormer or similar dormer would be here, and then we just have this. Now we're going to have two of those, and we sort of take that dormer, put it over here. Kind of.
Right. Well, one thing we noticed last time is the drawing on the bottom left shows a wall bracket picking up that shed, but it doesn't appear anywhere on the lower right elevation. And
right.
Then that roof with that wall bracket, that roof goes way up to somewhere, and I can't tell where it goes on the elevation on the right. The two elevations on the bottoms don't match each other.
Okay, so if you look at the enhanced, okay, side view, which is basically like a section through the existing house, right? The shed roof comes down.
You can see a wall bracket.
Right, with the wall bracket. The wall bracket was really an optional feature. You know, it's you don't have, the eave can end the way it's drawn on the right, but, you know, it's a decorative feature that, you know, kind of went with the post of the existing front porch and could be, you know, something nice, and it doesn't have to be there, is my point. It was just a way to kind of make it the roof line a little bit more interesting. There's a choice. So, you know, we could easily take it off, and then it matches exactly the what you're seeing in the southern elevation, where the basically the eave is just a little bit proud of where the posts are.
I don't know if we're objecting. We just want to be consistent. Which one do you want?
Well, I would, you know, I mean, it's really the bracket's not necessary. It doesn't have to be there. I like it, but it's, you know, I thought if it was a point of contention with, you know, in terms of the design, we could certainly eliminate it. It's certainly, if you want to be literally consistent with the rest of the house, then you would eliminate it. And that eave line would be much shorter the way it is across the existing, you know, front porch right now. And then we kind of carry that across below the two second story additions. If not, they could extend out and the brackets would work off of those posts.
Right. So, but even the one on the right, the posts almost seem to be right in the same plane as the addition. If you look at the upper right elevation, you have the posts coming either in the same plane or just in front of the new addition.
Yes, that's correct. Yep.
Well, which is it? Are they in the same plane or are they in front?
Well, they're literally touching the edge of the addition.
So go back to the lower right. So you have these diagonals in the post going right smack in front of the windows?
Yes, that's correct.
They're between
the windows, basically. If you look at the one that's underneath the proposed second story addition, it's basically falling right on where the trim is between the windows there.
But you have these diagonals in front of the windows.
Yeah, I mean, exactly. And that's picking up the, the detail on the, front porch.
But they're going right smack in front of the windows?
If that was kind of the intention. The idea was to make that visually read as, and essentially complement the front porch so that you'd have the structure of almost like a porch continuing all the way across the width of the two second story additions that would basically pick up, same detail on the front porch. How do I get back to the drawing here?
Architecturally, I find that very odd. I kind of understand what you're doing, but you're not drawing what makes sense to me.
Well, tell me what, you guys are thinking, and, we can certainly, work with it. It was just, the concept was basically to, try to pull that whole end of the house together by picking up on some of the more, interesting details of the existing house. The majority of the house to the west is fairly plain and flat and without detail until you get to the front entry porch. Then you get those kind of interesting, posts with the diagonal brackets. And the idea is to carry that across. One way to do this would be to eliminate them literally in front of the windows and carry them again across, new proposed covered porch that is, proud of the kitchen.
I mean, my problem is I hear what you're saying and what you're trying to do, but it's not really well depicted in any of the drawings to me. So on the left, you have a wall bracket, but you're saying it's either a wall bracket or a post. And then I look at the post and you have these posts with these diagonals right in front of the facade, which I don't know how you'll clean those windows. It just seems like a really odd detail that I don't think is thought through. And I just have a problem. I just don't feel the drawings are consistent and coherent to me.
And where are those posts on the left side elevation? Where are they drawn?
I think that's the whole issue. They're not there.
Yeah, but where would they be? No, bottom drawings on the left side. Where those posts would be? Because you should be able to see them, yes? When you look at this that view, you should be able to see them, I think.
Yeah, they would be, if you did the bracket, they would be depicted that they would be connected to that bracket, to that post.
They're totally different designs. One's got a bracket, the other's got posts kissing up against the windows.
But when you look at the elevation, the right side elevation on the upper right side, they are in line with that addition. And then on the bottom, then they would be, I just don't understand where are they on the, let's say if they were drawn, where would they be?
They would be drawn against the wall that the bracket is against.
Right, but okay. Then.
Almost like corner boards in a sense, but then you've got a few repeating on the flat facade.
Yeah, I mean, it would seem that they would work if they were actually posts and you had the eave extending out as far as you do on the left side elevation, and then they're actually posts, propping up the end of the eave. But
that's what I thought they were.
So okay.
That's the problem. That's not what's drawn. And what's drawn right now on two of the elevations are just a very odd detail that I'm sure you would not be happy with if it was made that way.
Yeah.
Well, let's go with your suggestion and let's put them, let's use the extended overhang, but get rid of the brackets and, put the posts there against the, on either end. They don't have to go in front of the windows.
we pointed all this out last week, and we wanted the architect to redraw it so it makes sense to us. And he, you know, we're getting the same drawings we saw last week.
Well, I apologize. I wasn't on last week, and I had contacted the village to speak with Tom and just get some feedback what your, you know, criticisms were. And he called me back about a week later and said he couldn't be reached until yesterday. I'd already resubmitted this stuff. So I apologize because I didn't get any of that feedback, but I'm, you know, happy to change it and make it coherent and, you know, make that one detail, you know, on your suggestion. I think it works, you know, either way. It could work with the brackets, without the posts, and just extend the roof line in front of the dining area with just the brackets, and then the posts pick up on either side. That would be nice. Or you could bring the eave out and have the posts all the way on the end and eliminate the brackets. And I didn't realize it was a point of contention. Otherwise, certainly I would have changed that. And you know, that's my fault. I apologize.
Right, but you're the designer, but there's an architect involved.
My partner and I designed together, and the and he's not on, but I'm here to, you know, speak for the two of us. Yeah.
So there's a big drop off from that porch too that needs a railing, I assume, right?
That's correct. And you know, the idea of the porch is that we would basically replicate all the details, you know, make the whole idea was to make it look like it's sitting on the existing porch and you know, keep every detail that is already there, from the railings to the steps to you know, the posts, that kind of thing. And you know, try to make this all blend so that it all, you know, complements the existing house. And you know, I think that the thing that we were looking at that we thought the priority was, and was that making sure the massing was correct, making sure that there was a concept with the roof lines that complemented what was there, trying to bring the that large second story existing addition kind of into the family of the roof lines, and by reproducing that and then bringing a shed off of that. You know, we think that it you know, basically enhances the house and makes it sit down. The rest of these details, I'm happy to change, but I think that, you know, hopefully you see what we were trying to get at in terms of trying to.
I hear what you're trying to do, and it all sounds like the right direction, but we look at the drawings, and they don't really show the correct massing, the correct details. You know, if you built the thing on the right with the post smack against the window, that would look funny to me. And if that's what you're going to build, I would say, no, you can't build that. If you're going to build what's on the left, then I'm going to say, well, build what's on, you know, then show the elevation on the right correctly.
Well, that's an easy fix. Also, I'm happy to do it.
Okay. And I realize you or your partner weren't on last week. And so we're asking you again to revise these drawings so they make sense. They show the drop-off in grade in that elevation. They show railings. They show whether you want a post or a wall bracket. You know, make sure the roof, shed roof is matching. I'm not sure if they do. You know, we spend time to, you know, volunteer our time, and we want to do it fruitfully.
I totally concur. And, you know, you guys are, you know, I appreciate the criticism and the feedback. We will make it right. I think it just involves a very, you know, small tweak. And I'm sorry that our emphasis was not there.
Just to make sure when you bring them back that the four elevations are consistent with each other, consistent and true with each other, and that you do have all the appropriate details. And if there's grading changes where something comes off, you know, don't say you can't see it, you know, show it. You know, we're professionals, we would understand if there's dotted lines, if something is grading changed and it's hidden behind something, you know, but
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. I'm happy to do it. Happy to do it.
All right. So we meet again in 2 weeks, right, Daisy?
We meet on July 1st, 7 p.m.
So you'll be automatically on the agenda. And we look forward to seeing you again then.
All right. Thank you so much for your time.
And David, when you do get the changes, if you can email them to me, in one PDF. That'd be great.
Okay, Daisy. Yeah, I have your email. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. Have a good night.
All right. You too.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Okay.
Sorry.
So, bye, Tamlin. And Paul. And David.
Is Tio part of the next session?
Tio Sequenza is part of the second one, yes.
Okay, so let me add him in.
And this is for 216 Croton Dam Road. Jeremy and Sarah Ween.
Good evening.
Hello.
Am I next? Good evening. Board member. Hello. Mr. DePaul.
Good evening.
Thank you for having me here and allowing me to present this project. I would like to share my screen.
Yes, please.
I will start with showing you an aerial map of the property. You can see my screen.
Yep.
Yes.
And so basically, as you can see here, the property is far back into the neighborhood that you can see here. And there's a long, very long driveway, in fact. To get to the property, you can see that pretty much you're starting here. You continue getting inside and drive onto the property. So that's like about, the property is like about 1,500 feet inside of the neighborhood. And the nearest homes, you know, as you can see, the home right here, that's like about 300 feet. This one is the closest, like about 200 and something feet. And all others are, you know, over 500 feet. Here we have a blow up of the property that you can see the aerial view and the proposal that we are presenting to you tonight takes place on the south west of the property, which would be about in an area like about here. You know, here's where the addition is being done. So I will show you now the neighbors and the existing house pictures. You know, you see the neighborhood is all, you know, rather very open in the sense that, you know, there's a lot of space among them. Some of them are difficult to photograph because the houses are so far in. But in general, the neighborhood really that you see outside when you drive is a little more traditional. The house that we have here in front of you, it's more of an 80s contemporary that I would call. So the house has its own features, as you can see here, existing house. So it has a lot of flat roofs, a few sloping roofs. And you can see that it's houses that we've seen many times built in the 80s. The addition that we're proposing is more on this side in here, and I will show you as I go around with the floor plans and show you the different areas. So that is the front of the house, basically the entry. And around here, you have the garage, which is basically here as you have turned the house. And then the back of the house, basically you can see here where this area is actually elevated decks in here. I will show you our proposal. Here you have the plan of the existing house with the additions. The additions that we're proposing I will show you generally, basically we are creating a kitchen here. And next to it, you know, there's an open air deck with a trellis on top. And this spacing here is basically an upper space of the lower level. If I was to go to the lower level, you will see in the basement that we are creating a small expansion of a movie theater that they have in here. But basically, that's all a byproduct of the kitchen expansion with the deck on next to it. So the red is the kitchen in here. We have the yellow in here is the deck, and the other one is the upper space of the basement level. So I will clear these images and show you the basement level so you can understand the immediate floor. So you can see here that again, the, some of these spaces are existing, but we are expanding. Again, the room that I'm going to show you, that I'm going to highlight in here is pretty much existing. And this space in here has been added. Actually existing to there, but this is one space in the basement level. And the rest is just spaces under the deck that you saw next to the kitchen, which would be this area here and this area here. So that is, in a nutshell, the plan work that we're proposing here. On the elevations, basically we are looking to continue with the house and not fight it. You saw these two elements in here that you see in the front of the house, these two half cylinders that will remain. And all this is the existing house. And basically here, there will be what you see of the expansion that we are proposing. Basically will be a section of one slope roof that you will barely see here. And then the rest will be siding. And beyond that, over the kitchen, basically is a deck terrace coming out of the master bedroom, just a byproduct of the room below. So this is what you will see in the front of the house. On the, I'm going to clear this in here. The next elevation that I will show you is the side and the rear. So the, well, on the elevation before, you could see actually the, I should have shown you this before, the, and I will annotate in here for clarity. You will see that again, we have the sloping roof here on the side. This is the side view, which kind of, you know, mimics, you know, the existing roof that you have in here sloping at the same angle. And the remainder that you will see here, basically, this volume will be the kitchen that I will probably just show you differently here. Rather, this will be the kitchen and the porches under, below the deck. So that is pretty much the scope of the work on this right-hand side elevation. I will clear this and show you the last elevation that basically where you will see a small section here on the side, which is the kitchen. Then you have the open deck. And there's actually an existing, a proposed rather, a mudroom that we are creating on the back of the house next to the garage. That is basically, I will highlight it in here now. That's a kitchen. This is the open porch in here. And then we have in here a small mudroom that also is seen in here on this last elevation as a continuation of the garage. So this pretty much summarizes the scope of the work that we are doing.
I'm fine with it.
I'm fine with it too. I think it's a nice, you know, it's a nice job. It's challenging to add to a unique house like this and make it feel like it, you know, kind of belongs. So yeah, I think it's nice.
Nicely done.
Yes. I like it too.
Okay, thank you. Very nice.
Thank you so much. Thank you, board members.
Thank you.
Good night.
Have a good evening.
Good night, Dale. Thank you.
Good night. Thank you so much.
All right.
Okay. So, Lyle, we can let Claudia in now.
He doesn't.
No, let's talk about her first before she comes on.
Do you want me to mute her?
I did before.
She's there.
Yeah, I'm here.
Who's your architect?
Let me just share the screen. So here. So first I'm going to show you maybe the, wait, I have, well, this is the site plan. Maybe I should show you first the photos. So here's the, are the photos. The property, my property is here on Bedford Road. And these are the neighboring houses. This is like a 2-acre property. And here I'll show you. Should I zoom in so you can see better?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this one, so I have a very long driveway that starts here and goes all the way to the house. And we share this driveway with these houses. So you first see this house and this one. These are the neighbors' houses. Then on the other side of the street, it's very wooded. A lot of landscaping around. So this is the only one you can see. It's, this is across this my driveway when you enter the property. And then and this one. And this is mine when you arrive through the driveway. That's the first thing you see, even though it's really, it's the view that is parallel from the Bedford Road, which you can't see the house. You can't see at all the house, even in this winter. It's too far and it's far and it's up. But let me also show you the, and this is the house. So the house was built in 1980 by a local architect from Chappaqua, actually. And it's a slab on grade. So we don't have a basement, we don't have attic, and it was a passive solar house, which means that this whole part of the house is like a solar radiation collector, and the heat is supposed to be transferred into this area, which is kind of like the living quarters. Then there's a carport, and there is this space, which originally, I think, for the people who built the house, it was a woodworking shop for the owner. That was his hobby. And for us, it served as a storage, really, because a gym storage kind of a thing, because we didn't have a basement and we don't have the attic. And so all this stuff was really, and now it became my office. So this is the area and I want to renovate it, renovate the office, and starting with residing and adding windows. Of course, it's a contemporary house. And so I want to even enhance and make it even more modern, if I may. So do you see the carport here? And this is that area. So first I'll talk about, so the project is two things. First, it's this renovation and the siding and the windows, and the other would be a shed, which I'm going to show you later. So this is that studio. You see blind facade here, and the only windows are on this side. So this is the plan. This is the existing. We are removing this the siding, and I'm going to add a tiny little bathroom to this space. That's another. These are existing elevations. So this is the work area. This is again the back of that studio, and this is the side. And I'm going to zoom in because you can't even see when it finishes, when it starts. But basically, this is that one of the areas, or one of the elevations. And this is the proposed. So I'm going to add this little bathroom. This is and a tiny window on the side, right above my desk. And then The treatment is going to be hardy. It's called reveal panels. I have photos of that, you know, towards the end of this folder package. So I'll show you. This is the front elevation that's going to be, you know, we had the same styles exactly like it was, but I'm just making it bigger. So bigger, more windows and less siding around. This is that little addition on that would be the shower area with this window. And in the back, I'm adding this window, that window. There's a compressor for the split unit that I have. And here, again, so that little addition has three windows, this one, and that one. Okay, so this is the studio. And then I'm going to show you the shed. So here's the shed as it is right now. It's a garden shed. We added some additional things that are falling apart each time there is some wind. So this is that. And we want to demolish this and build a new one. So it's very... So this is the plan of the shed. I don't know if you remember, but wait, this is where I'm going to go back to the site plan. But this is where the existing shed is, with those two plastic sheds near it. And that is going to be gone. And we would put in a very similar area that new shed, which is comprised in three volumes. So this three volumes, and in this would be like a gym area, and that should again. And so the materials here, when you facing the house, this is going to be the door, sliding door. And again, hardy panels, because we want to reside the whole house in that. And the cedar, this is going to be cedar, all windows around. So when you approach on the driveway, this is what you're going to see. You saw the pictures, you know, so this is what you see now, okay? When you approach through a driveway. And this is going to be what you're going to see now. This first volume, which is going to be in hardy, the gym in cedar, and the windows. And additionally to all the windows around, right below the roof, we have windows all over. So here, that's the southern elevation facing the neighbors. And this one is just facing this is the west. It's symmetrical to this one. And the materials, this is the panel system that I'm trying to, this is what I would like to use, and this is for residential. I'll show you, this shows you the color scheme, basically the white panels with the cedar planks. The planks are going to be 6 inch wide. And I think I had like a little detail here that you can see how it would be detailed on the shed. So that's my presentation.
Will she require planning board approval?
I'm in the setbacks, and I also did the analysis of the coverage, and I'm in it.
I think Daisy might be referring to the accessory apartment possibility that you're putting in.
Oh. Well, no, it's not going to be heated. I don't think it's...
How are you having a bathroom without it?
No, I'm talking about, you're talking about this one, yes?
The shed, yeah. Well,
no. The shed doesn't have a bathroom. It doesn't have plumbing. It only has electricity for lights and some outlets, because I'll have like a, you know.
When I get the site plan, I'll go through it to see if you need planning board approval or any zoning, once I see it full size. The zoning, it seems like you're within the setbacks.
Yes, I'm within the setbacks. And let me see. Yeah, I was doing the zoning analysis quite carefully, so that I actually wanted to have it even bigger, but the zoning analysis in this page, but it somehow you can't. Anyway, it's going to be up to you. It's not up to ARB, but I mean, it's not the area. We won't talk about that for it's too much time for. But I'm within the setbacks. Okay. And the only bathroom is here, yes. That one.
All right, so that's not an accessory apartment or possibility to be an accessory apartment?
No, not really, because, I mean, I do have that split unit, but, you know.
How about
a nice shed, yeah.
A bedroom.
But I would be allowed to have a bedroom. I'm on a sewer, even if I wanted to.
Yeah, absolutely. No, I'm just trying to look at all avenues.
Right. No. You know, if I was in septic, which I was up until last year. Stanley knows the story. That's why.
Came onto my street.
So that would have been consideration. But even on a septic, you are allowed to expand 1,000 square feet for a three bedroom. I think you can double check and look into it, and whatever it's needed, I'll.
I think because it's not just a shed for storage, I'm just wondering if it's gonna flag planning board as an accessory, it's a second structure.
Well, I, not that it matters here, but I've done something in New Jersey where it was connected with the roof, like our carport roof connects with the house. Mm-hmm. So in that jurisdiction, they considered it part of the house.
Okay.
But, you know, it's up to Tom and the planning board.
Well, this is existing, yes? The studio, you mean?
Right. Yeah.
The studio is an existing structure. I'm only adding to, the only addition to it, it's the bathroom. But I think Daisy is referring
to that.
Well, okay.
Basically being,
a separate structure.
Right, but it's you know, I'm demolishing the existing garden shed and making two, but it's not going to be heated.
Making a really nice gardening shed.
Really nice shed.
I know. My daughter says I'm moving in. That's exactly what she said. No worries.
I'll take a look at it and I'll tell you if there's a problem.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Fine with me.
Looks very nice.
Thank you very much.
Really nice, yes.
Nice presentation.
I'm sorry?
We're not going to make you come back?
He has to come back next week.
Yes. Well, thank you very much.
I didn't see a roof plan for the gardening shed.
Oh, actually, there is a framing here. I have a framing.
Okay.
But no.
I was looking at the old.
I bet it's going to be a flat roof, EPDM.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me see. Wow. Yeah, this is my secondary structure as it is. No.
Very nice.
Yeah. Well, this is White Shed Foundation. I don't think I have it here, but Tom has it in his.
No worries.
Because I prepared the set only for us. Or the ARB.
The file is on my desk in the ARB basket.
Yeah. Yeah, so Tom has everything, details and all the everything.
All right, I'll pull them in the morning and start looking at it.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I think we're good.
Yep.
Thanks.
Lyle,
thank you.
Everybody, bye.
Bye.
Good evening, yeah.
Are we
done? I think we need to let Lyle know that we're done, yes.
We are done, okay.
All right, thank you, Lyle. Have a good night, everyone. Bye, Lyle.